See, adenohyperphysis secretes 6 hormones, I told you. One is growth hormone, thyrotrophic hormone or thyroid stimulating hormone. Third, adrenocorticotrophic hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, prolactin. These are the hormones secreted from adenohyperphysis. Neurohyperphysis stores two hormones. One is oxytocin and another one is vasopressin. So oxytocin and vasopressin are the hormone stored in neurohyperphysis. Then it goes into the other part. Right. Now first let us take growth hormone. What is the role of growth hormone? See, the name itself, it has got its meaning. It takes part in general growth of the body. Skeletal development. So that is the role. So growth hormone plays very important role for carbohydrate, protein, fat metabolism. See this slide. You will have the role of growth hormone I have given. Growth hormone. It promotes the development and enlargement of all tissue of the body. It stimulates the growth of muscles, cartilages and long bone. See, the skeletal system development is under the control of growth hormone. Bone development. Then it controls cell metabolism. I told you carbohydrate, protein, fat metabolism. Is it clear? Now, improper secretion of growth hormone may lead to certain conditions called dwarfism, gigantism, acromegaly. What is called dwarfism? See the next slide. Love dwarfism. Decreased secretion of growth hormone in children. குழந்தைங்களுக்கு growth hormone கம்மியா சொன்னதுன்னா ஒரு 13 வயசு கீழே இருக்கும் வரக்கூடிய டிசீஸ் dwarfism. Retarded growth, stunted growth, delayed skeletal formation, எலும்பு வளர்ச்சி கம்மியா இருக்கும், mental disability. So poor mental ability. These are the characteristic features of dwarfism. They will ask in 2 mark question. What is dwarfism? Write the characteristics of dwarfism. Very important 2 mark question. So dwarfism is less secretion of growth hormone in children may lead to the condition called dwarfism. Right. The next one, when growth hormone secreted enormous amount. See, when growth hormone secreted in enormous amount, what happened? In children, gigantism will occur. What is called gigantism? 7 feet or 9 feet height. In the Isla Ariukala Mutti Niko. Gigantism. Characterized by overgrowth of all body tissue and organs. Abnormal increase in height. This is the symptoms of gigantism, gigantic growth. Then excess secretion of growth hormone in adult may lead to the condition called acromegaly. See, the excess secretion of growth hormone in adult leads to the condition acromegaly. Abnormal enlargement of head, face, hand and feet. They are also called gorilla man. Gorilla man appdin solluvaanga. Kai kala neat neat a irukku. Jaws la nalla thick and a irukku. The joint la pathina mootu nalla veeng pona maari. Thickened joints. Abnormal enlargement. Face, feet, hand. These are the symptoms of acromegaly. பாக்குறது காலி மாதிரியே இருக்கும். அதனால அக்ரோ மெகாலி. சோ அப்நார்மல் செக்ரீஷன் இன் தி சேம் தட் ஹைப்பர் செக்ரீஷன் ஹைப்போ செக்ரீஷன். ஹைப்பர் செக்ரீஷன் இன் அடல்ட் லீட்ஸ் டு தி கண்டிஷன் கால்ட் அக்ரோ மெகாலி. இன் சில்ட்ரன் இட் இஸ் ஜைஜாண்டிஸ். லெஸ் செக்ரீஷன் மே லீட்ஸ் டு தி கண்டிஷன் கால்ட் டுவார்பிசம். புள்ளமா இருப்பாங்க, புள்ள மனிதர்கள். ரைட். திஸ் இஸ் அபவுட் growth hormone. Now the next one is thyroid stimulating hormone TSH. See, the thyroid stimulating hormone, it controls growth of thyroid gland, coordinate its activity and hormone secretion. The thyroid gland, see here, thyrotrophic hormone or TSH. This hormone secreted from adenohypophysis reaches into thyroid gland. Now see, this is the thyroid gland. It stimulates the thyroid gland to secrete its respective hormone. Its respective hormone is thyroxine. Right. So in dwarfism, in children, less secretion in the same below 13 years, when growth hormone secretion is very less, this condition is called dwarfism. The individual attains stunted growth, poor skeletal development, but other organs in their body, it will somewhat attain maximum growth, but the skeletal system growth arrested. Sometimes sexual organ development also may be affected. There are some complications are there. That is dwarfism. The individuals are very short. Dwarfism. That is called dwarfism. Right. See here, thyroid stimulating hormone, I told you, this hormone reaches into thyroid gland where it stimulates the thyroid gland to secrete its respective hormone called thyroxine. Thyroxine controls general metabolism. Right, that is the role of TSH. Thyroid gland thundrathunala idhu par thyroid stimulating hormone. Right. Now next hormone, see, adrenocorticotrophic hormone, adrenal cortex stimulating hormone. Adrenal cortex stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotrophic hormone. And this hormone reaches into adrenal gland. See, adrenal gland consists of two regions. See, now imagine this is the adrenal gland. It has got two area. One is adrenal cortex. See, this is adrenal cortex. And the inner part contain adrenal medulla. Paranga, idu mele adrenal cortex, ulle medulla. In the adrenal cortex, la poi reach out in the arm. Adenohypophysis la secrete aayi adrenal cortex mattum po. So it stimulates adrenal cortex to secrete its respective hormone called the mineralocorticoid hormone and glucocorticoid hormone. So mineralocorticoid and glucocorticoid hormone are secreted from adrenal cortex. That mineralocorticoid hormone regulate minerals and it take part in reabsorption of certain minerals in the nephron is under the control of this adrenal cortex hormones. Glucocorticoid hormone regulate glucose level. That we will see in adrenal gland. Right. So growth hormone, I told you, thyroid stimulating hormone stimulate thyroid gland to secrete its respective hormone. Adrenocorticotrophic hormone stimulate adrenal cortex of adrenal gland and their respective hormones are secreted. Now let's see the follicle stimulating hormone FSH. See, follicle stimulating hormone. That means these hormones secreted from adenohypophysis reaches into ovary of female, testes of male. In the case of female, what happened? See, this is the structure of ovary. Interior to ovary, you can find various stages of development of egg cell. It is related to their menstrual cycle period. See, in the case of female, once they attain sexual maturity after the age of 13, what happened? Periodical rhythmic changes taking place in the ovary and uterus. This is called menstrual cycle. It has got four phases. The first phase, bleeding phase, 1 to 5 days. From 6th to 14th day, what happened? Follicular phase, we can see. Here, germinal epithelial cell undergo growth. Now, one of the egg develops and the egg is surrounded by follicle cell. So, this is called the graafian follicle. Inside the graafian follicle, you can find the ovum. So here the hormone FSH, follicle stimulating hormone secreted from adenohypophysis, reaches into ovary of female. It stimulates graafian follicle cell. so that the growth of ovum takes place. Maturation of ovum takes place. And at the same time, what happened? Here, the graafian follicle cell secrete hormone called estrogen. Estrogen, female sex hormone. That hormone secretion is also under the control of this follicle stimulating hormone. This is in the case of female. In case of male, human beings, male, what happened? The same follicle stimulating hormone from adenohypophysis reaches into testes. See the structure of testes. Inside the testes, you can find a number of cylindrical tubules called seminiferous tubule. Inside the seminiferous tubule, what happened? Sperm production will be taking place. Spermatogenesis. So, spermatogenesis process is under the control of follicle stimulating hormone. So that is why it is called follicle stimulating hormone. In female, it stimulates the graafian follicle cell so that it provides nourishment for developing oocyte. In male, it takes part in spermatogenesis in the testes. That is the role of follicle stimulating hormone. Right. The next hormone is luteinizing hormone. See, the luteinizing hormone, it is secreted in the case of female. It reaches into ovary. See here, in ovary what happened? It takes part in ovulation. What is called ovulation? See the graafian follicle cell, interior part contain egg cell. The egg cell will come out of the ovary. And this process is called ovulation. So ovulation is under the control of LH, luteinizing hormone. So, luteinizing hormone take part in ovulation. See here, it take part in ovulation. What is called ovulation? Release of ovum from graafian follicle cell. It takes place exactly at 14th day of menstrual cycle in female. Right, it's over. After ovulation, what happened? The empty graafian follicle cell get converted into yellow color mass of cell. This is called corpus luteum. Corpus luteum. This corpus luteum secrete hormone called progesterone or pregnancy hormone. It prepares uterus for implantation. That we will discuss in another chapters. There you will have sexual reproduction in human being. There we will see a detailed account of corpus luteum and other things. So, corpus luteum maintenance is also under the control of luteinizing hormone. So, these two hormones, FSH and LH, plays very important role for controlling gonads. So, it is called the gonadotropic hormone. This is two more questions. What is called the gonadotropic hormone? The term gonadotropic, the hormone which stimulates the gonad, so that gonads secrete its respective hormones. So they are called gonadotropic hormone. Which are gonadotropic hormone? One more question. Follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone. Both are called gonadotropic hormone. Right. With that we have completed that too. The last one is prolactin. What is called prolactin? It is also called lactogenic hormone. These hormones secreted from adenohypophysis reaches into the female, it stimulates the mammary gland. Myoepithelial cells of female breast so that now it can secrete milk after parturition. After childbirth, what happened? Milk secretion will be carried out. So, the prolactin is responsible for the development of mammary gland. That is the major role. So, that it is called lactogenic hormone, milk secreting. I mean, stimulating hormones, we can say. Right. These are the six hormones secreted from adenohypophysis. Now let us pass on to neurohypophysis. See, the neurohypophysis stores two hormones. One is oxytocin and another one is vasopressin. Oxytocin is also called rapid birth hormone. Rapid birth hormone. Why they are called rapid birth hormone? Now, it takes part at the time of childbirth, parturition. Say, for example, in the case of pregnant lady, prior to parturition. Now, prior to parturition, 2 or 3 days before parturition, what happened? These hormones are secreted. These hormones reaches into uterus where it contract uterus muscle so that the child will be easily propelled out. The normal delivery will be taking place. So as a result of contraction of muscles in the uterus, the child will be propelled out. This is called the parturition, childbirth. So oxytocin hormone contract uterus in female. This is the first role. Its second role is it contract the myoepithelial cells of breast so that milk ejection will be taking place. The first mother milk is called colostrum. The colostrum production is under the control of this oxytocin hormone. So it has got two major roles. One for contraction of uterus and another one for contraction of myoepithelial cells of breast of female. So these are the two functions. Right. The next hormone is vasopressin. It is also called antidiuretic hormone, ADH. What is called the ADH? Antidiuretic hormone, vasopressin. These hormone plays very important role for the formation of urine formation. So it take part in retention of certain minerals, release of certain unwanted minerals during the formation of urine. You know, the urine formation, it takes place in the kidney by means of nephron. In nephron, what happened? The process called the glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption, tubular secretion. These are all some process in which urine formation taking place in the kidney. So urine extracted from the blood by means of these three processes. So in these processes, tubular reabsorption is under the control of ADH. So it retained water. In the body. So that it is called antidiuretic hormone. So urine diluted ah porada thadukkudi hormone appo idu enna pannu concentrated urine porudhu kaaranam ah so concentrated urine formation is under the secretion of this hormone. That means it retain water, reabsorb water in the uriniferous tubule. That is the role antidiuretic hormone. Suppose if the hormone is secreted less, deficiency of this hormone may lead to the condition called diabetes insipidus. This is also on two markers. What is called diabetes insipidus? Less secretion of or deficient production of ADH hormone may lead to the condition called diabetes insipidus. In this case, person can excrete an enormous amount of urine. Polyuria, release of large quantities of urine without sugar. Sugar complaint, that is called diabetes mellitus. But here it is diabetes insipidus. Insipidus is different from diabetes mellitus. So, person can excrete enormous amount of urine. Now, that condition is called diabetes insipidus. That means this hormone less production may lead to release of enormous amount of water along with urine. So diluted urine will come out instead of concentrated urine. So that condition is called diabetes insipidus. Right. So this is about vasopressin. So it sometimes it causes a contraction of blood vessel so that blood pressure increases. Hence it is named as vasopressin. Another name, vasopressin. So these are the roles of oxytocin and vasopressin. With that, I have completed the hormone secreted from pituitary gland. See why the pituitary gland is called master of endocrine system. Thyroid stimulating hormone control thyroid gland. Adrenocorticotropic hormone control adrenal cortex of adrenal gland. Follicle stimulating hormone now control gonad in the case of male and female. Spermatogenesis, oogenesis process. Luteinizing hormone in the case of female, it take part in ovulation and corpus luteum maintenance. Whereas in male, this hormone is also called interstitial cell stimulating hormone, ICSH. It stimulates leading cells of testis so that testosterone hormone is secreted. Male sex hormone. That is under the control of ICSH. Interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Then I told you prolactin, lactogenic hormone. Then neurohypophysis has got two hormones, oxytocin and vasopressin. So this is about pituitary gland. So with that, I have completed pituitary gland. This is one of the very vast endocrine system. It has got connection with other endocrine system also. So go through that in a clear way. So it is very important. Tharava padichinga. Now let us pass on to thyroid gland. Thyroid gland points the next slide. See the thyroid gland. Thyroid gland is located in the neck. You know, larynx, behind the larynx you can find, see the larynx contain on both sides thyroid gland. It has got two lobes. Here, Adilla. Right, this is the structure of thyroid gland. It consists of two lobes lying on one on either side of the trachea. The two lobes are connected by means of a band of tissue called isthmus. See the structure of thyroid gland, you know, here. Thyroid gland, it has got two lobes. Right. This is the thyroid cartilage bone and it is followed by trachea. You can draw the diagram in an easy way. This is the trachea. Now, at the lateral side of the larynx, you can find the lobed structure. This lobed structure is called thyroid gland. Now, imagine this is the structure of thyroid gland. It has got many lobes. The diagram slide will come. See, the diagram will be looking like this. The two lobes are connected by means of the connective tissue called isthmus. See, this is called isthmus. Is it clear? Right. Now, the lobes internally, it consists of enormous number of lobules. When you take the section of thyroid gland and it is visible under a microscope, you can see a number of follicles. Many number of small bubble-like structures or follicle structures. These follicles are called thyroid follicle, or it is otherwise called acinus. See, this is thyroid follicle. This thyroid follicle secrete or produce hormone called thyroxine. The thyroxine is also denoted as T4. It also secretes T3, triiodothyronin. See, this is the thyroid follicle. Internally, it consists of colloidal substances called thyroxine hormone. Now, in between thyroid follicle, you can find connective tissue, blood vessels, and other parts. When you take the section of lobe, you can find lobules. Again, internally, lobules contain a number of thyroid follicle. The thyroid follicle composed of cubical epithelial cells, or simple cuboidal epithelial cells. That cell secrete hormone called the thyroxine. So that thyroxine here it is stored. Whenever needed, it reaches through bloodstream, then it reaches into various parts of the body. This is the structure of thyroid gland. Now, what is the role of thyroid hormone? See, thyroxine is called thyroid hormone. T3, triiodothyronin. T1, monoiodothyronin. These are the hormone from SCNS. SCNS means the thyroid follicle. Right. What is the function of this thyroid gland? When hormone is secreted less, what will happen? When hormone is secreted, excess secretion, what will happen? So that we are going to see in a detailed way now. Now let us see the functions of thyroid glands. Go through the slides. The diagram of the thyroid gland is located here. See, this is the diagram. Here you can nalla enlarge panna. Diagram theriyala ungalukku. See, the thyroid cartilage followed by thyroid gland. At the base of the thyroid gland, two bulged structures are there. That is parathyroid gland. So it is located at the lateral side of the larynx in the neck region. Right. This is the structure which is given in your book. Practice that. Right. Now let's see the next one. The functions of thyroid hormone. I told you thyroxine hormone. See, the thyroxine increases consumption. Increases oxygen consumption in the tissue. Now you know thyroxine hormone plays very important role in tissue oxidation. It plays very important role in basal metabolism. So production of energy by maintaining the basal metabolic rate of the body. You know, basal metabolic rate. What do you mean by that, basal metabolic rate? Now, when we are at complete rest, what happened? There are some chemical activity taking place in the cell. Oxygen used for breaking glucose to release energy. So, a kind of Krebs cycle process, energy producing process taking place at resting state. That is called the basal metabolic rate. So, thyroxine plays very important role for tissue oxidation. Or basal metabolic rate of the body. It helps to maintain normal body temperature. As a result of metabolism, what happens? ATP is produced, adenosine triphosphate, that is heat energy. When heat energy is produced, it is distributed to various parts of the body so that it can regulate the distribution of temperature. Right. It also influences the activity of central nervous system. Nervous system development is also under the control of thyroxine hormone. So thyroxine hormone during the embryo formation, it plays very important role for nervous system development, brain development, spinal cord development. Right. Control growth of the body, bone formation and development of gonad. Normal growth of the body also depends upon thyroxine hormone. Bone formation, skeletal development, gonadal development. If thyroxine hormone is less in childhood stage, what happens? It leads some kind of sexual dysfunctions at the later stages. So gonadal dysfunctions. So it is essential for development of gonads, testes and ovary. It is also essential for normal physical, mental and personality development. Here, the personality development, what do you mean by that? In each and every cell, it takes part in metabolism. As a result of metabolism, it produces energy. So, this energy maintains our body in an active state. That is why it is called metabolism. It maintains personality. So, it is called personality hormone, which is called personality hormone, thyroxine. It regulates carbohydrate, protein and fat metabolism. So these are the functions of thyroxine hormone. You go through any four of the functions of thyroxine hormone. If they ask in four mark question, you can write this. Right. With that, I have completed the function. Now coming to the regarding the structure of thyroid gland. Edward C. Candle. In 1914, discovered the crystallized thyroxine hormone. Who discovered the crystallized thyroxine hormone? One more question. Edward C. Candle. Charles Harrington and George Varga identified the molecular structure of thyroxine hormone in 1927. It is given in the box. You go through that also. Anyone will come under one more question. The thyroid gland requires 120 microgram of iodine every day for the production of thyroxine. See, the thyroxine hormone, I told you, thyroxine hormone chemically composed of iodine mineral salt part and protein part called thyrosine. Is it clear? See, when you see the structure of thyroxine hormone, chemically it is composed of tyrosine amino acid part plus iodic minerals. Right. Here, now let move to thyroid dysfunctions. Thyroxine hormone, korava sonnalo, adhima sonnalo, for a condition, hypothyroidism, hyperthyroidism, abdin sol. Hypo na korava sorakiradhu nartham. Hyper na adhima secrete aagudhu nartham. So, hyposecretion of thyroxine hormone leads to the condition called gaiter-cretinism mixedema. Hypersecretion leads to the condition called Graves' disease. Either naal disease nalla tharava padichunu edaachu onnu tumor la kaam. What are the characteristic features of cretinism? What is Graves' disease? Write its symptom. Write the symptoms of mixedema. So, very, very important question. Or in 4-mark question, they will ask, write a note on thyroid dysfunctions. There you are supposed to write hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. See, in hypothyroidism, goiter, first let's take goiter. You know, the goiter is nothing but, see, look at the diagram in your book. The goiter, thyroid gland swelling takes place in the person who are suffering from goiter disease. Kaluthu nalla undagatti maaridha maari peeing irupar. Goiter. Swelling of thyroid gland. This condition occur in person who are living in Himalayan areas. So it is caused due to inadequate supply of iodine in our diet. Iodine kammiya irukra edathila indha maari problem. Thyroxine hormone korava varum. Pituitary gland stimulate pannine irukum. Thyrotrophic hormone nareya sorum. Thyroid gland structure la perusa avum. Ana thyroxine produce avum. Appo andha thyroid gland veengite pogum. That is called goiter. It is prevalent in Himalayan region where low concentration of iodine in the soil. Enlargement of thyroid gland which protrude as marked swelling in the neck and it is called a goiter. What is called a goiter? There are two types of goiter. Here it is simple goiter. One more goiter, that is exophthalmic goiter. Graves' disease is also called exophthalmic goiter. That is due to hypersecretion of these hormones. Right. Next slide. Here you can find cretinism. Cretinism. Less secretion of thyroid hormone in children may leads to the condition called cretinism. 13 vayasukku keela idu yaarukla korava varugudho avangalukku cretinism varum. Now person who are having cretinism is characterized by stunted growth, kullamana valarchi, mental defect, lack of skeletal development and deformed bones. So deformed bones idella vandu pathina avangalude characteristic features. Individuals who are suffering from these diseases are denoted as cretins. Cretins. Who are called cretins? யாருக்கு கிரெட்டினிசம் இருக்குதோ அவங்களை கிரெட்டின்ஸ்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. The characteristic features of cretinism is very important to 2-mark question. Go through that. Then, next disease is myxedema. Myxedema. What is called myxedema? Deficiency of thyroid hormone in adults. So cretinism in children, myxedema in adults. It is characterized by mental sluggishness. நல்லா மத மதம் இருக்கும், எந்த வேலையும் செய்யாம தூங்கினே இருக்கும். மென்டல் ஸ்லகிஷ்னஸ், எவ்வளோ பாய போட்டு அழு. இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் பாடி வெயிட், உடம்பு நல்லா குண்டா இருக்கும், சதை போட்டுக்கிட்டே போவோம், சோம்பேறித்தனம் அதிகமாகும். பஃபினஸ் இன் த ஃபேஸ், முகம் நல்லா பப்ஸ் மாதிரி வீங்கி போயிடும். ஹேண்ட் எடிமேட்டஸ் அப்பியரன்ஸ், நல்லா உப்பி போன முகம், உப்பி போன உடம்பு, தண்ணி கோத்துனா எப்படி இருக்கும், உடம்பு வீக்கத்துல அந்த மாதிரி மிக்சடிமா. சோ அந்த டம் நல்லா பாத்தீங்க, மிக்சடிமா. ஐ மீன் டெஃபிஷியன்ட் செக்ரீஷன், லெஸ் செக்ரீஷன் ஆஃப் தைராக்சின் ஹார்மோன் இன் அடல்ட் லீட்ஸ் டு தி கண்டிஷன் கால் மிக்சடிமா. எடிமா, அக்குமுலேஷன் ஆஃப் வாட்டர். சோ தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் ஹைபோதைராய்டிசம். நவ் லெட் இஸ் பாஸ் ஆன் டு ஹைப்பர் தைராய்டிசம், கிரேவ்ஸ் டிசீஸ், exophthalmic goiter. See, excess secretion may lead to this condition. Now, what are the symptoms of Graves' disease? Now, person who are having Graves' disease have protrusion of eyeball. கண்ணு நல்லா பிரிங்க வெளியில வந்துடும், முண்டை கண்ணு மாறாத மாதிரி வெளியில வந்து நிற்கும். அதனாலதான் எக்ஸோப்தால்மிக் காய்டர், எக்ஸோ வெளியில, ஆப்தால்மிக் கண்ணு, கண்ணு வெளியில பிதிங்கன்னு இருக்கிற காய்டர். இன்க்ரீஸ்டு மெட்டபாலிக் ரேட், பேசல் மெட்டபாலிக் ரேட் அதிகமாக, ஹை பாடி டெம்பரேச்சர், சாப்பிட்டதெல்லாம் சீக்கிரமா எனர்ஜியா மாறும், அதனால மெட்டபாலிக் ரேட் அதிகமாக, டெம்பரேச்சர் அதிகமாக, ப்ரொஃபியூஸ் ஸ்வெட்டிங், லாஸ் ஆஃப் பாடி வெயிட், நர்வஸ்னஸ், உடம்பு ஒல்லியா இருக்கும், அடிக்கடி டென்ஷன் ஆகும், நர்வஸ்னஸ் இருக்கும், அடிக்கடி டென்ஷன் ஆகும், திட்டினே இருப்பாங்க, யார் பார்த்தாலும் திட்டினே இருப்பாங்க. இதுதான் எக்ஸாப்தால்மிக் காய்டர். அந்த கிரிட்டினிசத்துல நல்லா குண்டா இருப்பாங்க, இதுல நல்லா ஒல்லியா இருக்கும். இதுதான் அதுக்கு உள்ள இதுக்கு உள்ள வித்தியாசம். இதுல குளுக்கோஸ் சீக்கிரமா காலியாகும், அதுல அப்படியே மத மதன்னு இருக்கும். இதுதான் கிரேவ்ஸ் டிசீஸ். ஸோ டிஸ்பங்க்ஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தைராய்டு கிளான்ஸ் ஆர் ஒன் இஸ் காய்டர், அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் கிரிட்டினிசம், அண்ட் நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் மிக்சடிமா. ஹைப்பர் செக்ரேஷன் ஆஃப் தைராக்சின் ஹார்மோன் மே லீட்ஸ் டு த கண்டிஷன் கால்டு கிரேவ்ஸ் டிசீஸ். இதுல எதை ஒன்னாலும் டூ மார்க் குவெஸ்டன்ல கேரக்டரிஸ்டிக் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் கேட்பாங்க, அது நல்லா தரவு பண்ணீங்க, வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். இஃப் தே ஆஸ்க் த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் தைராய்டு கிளாண்ட், யூ டிரா த டயக்ராம் ஆஃப் தைராய்டு கிளாண்ட். இந்த டயக்ராம் வரைஞ்சிட்டு இதுக்குண்டான அந்த பார்ட்ஸ், ரெண்டு லோப் இருக்குது, டூ லோப்ஸ் ஆர் கனெக்டட் பை இஸ்துமஸ், ஈச் லோப் கண்டெயின் மெனி லோபியூல்ஸ், இன்சைட் லோபியூல்ஸ் யூ கேன் ஃபைண்ட் மெனி நம்பர் ஆஃப் பாலிகில்ஸ், தட் பாலிகில்ஸ் ஆர் கால்டு தைராய்டு பாலிகில், இட் செக்ரி ஹார்மோன் கால்டு தைராக்சின், தைராக்சின் ஹார்மோன் விட அது டி ஃபோர்னு சொல்லுவாங்க, இதோட சேர்ந்து டி த்ரீ டி ஒன் மோனோ அயோடோ தைரோனின், ட்ரை அயோடோ தைரோனின் இதெல்லாம் இருக்குது அப்படின்னு இதில் நீங்கள் சொல்ல வேண்டியதுதான். தைராக்சின் கெமிக்கலி கம்போஸ்ட் ஆஃப் புரோட்டீன் பார்ட் கால்டு தைரோசின் அண்ட் மினரல் பார்ட் கால்டு அயோடின். ஸோ அயோடின் இஸ் எசென்சியல் ஃபார் த ஃபார்மேஷன் ஆஃப் தைராக்சின் ஆர். இதான் தைராய்டு கிளாண்டோட ஸ்ட்ரக்சர். ஸோ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஃபோர் மார்க் கொஸ்டின் ஆர் செவன் மார்க் கொஸ்டின். இது ரெண்டுமே செவன் மார்க் கொஸ்டின் தான், அல்லது ஃபோர் மார்க் கொஸ்டின்ல ஏதாவது ஷார்ட்கட் பண்ணி கேட்கலாம். ஸோ இதில் எப்படிலாம் கொஸ்டின் கேட்கலாம், ரைட் த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் தைராய்டு கிளாண்ட், write the functions of thyroid gland separate to 4 mark questions, write the dysfunctions of thyroid gland idu or thani 4 mark question adile thani thaniya kuduthirukku parunga goiter symptom, myxedema symptom, cretinism symptom, ectopthalmic goiter symptom idala thani thani 2 mark questions adha pituitary gland la gigantism, acromegaly, dwarfism idala thani thani 2 mark questions. ஸோ இதோட ரெண்டு எண்டோக்ரைன் கிளான்ஸை நம்ம முடிச்சிருக்கிறோம், மீதி எண்டோக்ரைன் கிளான்ஸை நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸில் பார்த்துக்கலாம். தேங்க்யூ டு ஆல்.